So 3 years ago, New Zealand was devastated by the Christchurch earthquakes. But luckily, we had a great rescue team in place, and the life loss was much prevented. But then 3 months later, the Pike River Mine explosion happened. And unfortunately, it's been 3 years, and the miners are still waiting to be rescued. Attempts to enter the mine were just made last week. So I thought, what's this hold up for? It's probably unsafe for the miners, for the rescue team to enter, but what about technology? It's 2013, shouldn't there be something to do this for us? And I found out that soon later, 3 weeks later, 4 robots were ordered from Australia. Now that's where the first bit of annoying information came in. And there was nothing like this in New Zealand. Everything was in Australia, so we had to order it. And then 3 weeks later, the robots arrived. According to the Pike River Mine Inquiry, the miners would have lost their lives in half an hour. So the only way to get in them and save them was to have a mine have a robot on standby at the mine. So I decided, how hard can it be to make my own robot for saving lives? It was harder than I thought, but I still tried to work as a researcher and listed the problem I had, the problem I wanted to try to solve. So with the Pike River Mine disaster, those 4 robots came in. And then, first thing, they weren't in New Zealand. Secondly, they all failed because they weren't waterproof. So they were specifically made for mining conditions, but they weren't waterproof. So that's one problem to solve. Those robots were worth $150,000 each. So basically, that's $600,000 of waste just lying there. And I decided to look at the Christchurch earthquake as well to see if there's any way I can squeeze in technology to do the search and rescue work. And I found one story of a dog who found a rabbit and made authorities dig up this huge area just to find a rabbit instead of humans. And that added much frustration to them. So in a broader perspective, basically the problem I was trying to solve was the high cost of technology. Because if those robots were much cheaper, then each mine in New Zealand would have them to prevent Pike River explosions trying to affect life. So I looked at current solutions out there. So first was the dog. That's the current primary method for urban search and rescue to use in New Zealand. So they cost $22,000 over a period of 3 years to train. And obviously that is a bit of a long time, and that doesn't mean that they will be ready for working in the search and rescue conditions. They can be distracted. So as you saw with the rabbit, it was distracted and it was misled the authorities. Also, it has a non-replaceable battery, as in it can't work like technology does. You have to get food and rest. There's also safety issues for the dog handler and the dog itself when it's trying to go through rubble finding life due to unstable buildings. Then I found this robot, an affordable one, and it's currently used for intelligence and military purposes in America. But it has a really small range, so the controller would be at risk from unstable buildings again. It wasn't waterproof, so that doesn't solve the first problem. And it can be much cheaper than the $7,000 that they currently sell it for. So after thinking all this, I came up with my own solution, Tyco. So it's a rover that goes into mines and into rubble. So it's small but powerful. And basically, there's a video output from the rover in real time for the operator to see what it's doing and what it's found. There's sensor data, including gas sensor levels and temperature levels, for the authorities to see if it's possible for humans to enter the mine. And it has a choice of autonomous control, so it can basically go out on its own and map out the area for authorities. Or it can be used by a user for more control and more speed. So why Tyco? Why is it better than the other solutions that you guys saw? Well, it's cheap. It's only around $200 to $250, depending on the battery you choose. That makes it 92% cheaper than the little robot Scout Recon XT, 98% cheaper and safer to use than a dog. Also, it's efficient, as in you can put any sensor you want on it, so a Gaia counter can be put on it to measure nuclear radiation. It's multi-terrain. I've tested it in construction sites, rocky terrain, and mud, so it can work in rubble and in mine situations. It's long range, so it has a theoretical range of 20 kilometers that provides it's safe for the user and mine situations to stay away from gas levels as well as rubble. And it's cool at the same time. Video is outputted into these head-mounted displays, and basically that provides a first-person view of the robot in work and as if you're just driving a car. So I got together with a friend, Vandan Patel, and decided to make this for the Google Science Fair. So we started off with a teacher for the first design in the red, and basically that was to test the motor and the program working. After that, I found it was way too weak for it to work in grass. So we decided to go and build it further, and we came up with the one with the phone in it. And that's what we entered into the Google Science Fair. Now, we found that not only can it be used for mud and rocky terrain, but it makes a great companion for your little one. After all, the dog is the man's best friend. And so, basically, my friend and my teacher got busy with other stuff, so I decided to continue it on my own. And here's Tyke now. So basically, right now, it's autonomous, so it can avoid objects and navigate successfully. This video input works on those cool glasses, and it also returns carbon monoxide and methane levels back to the user. So, you know, I'm still not finished. Here's what's next. Basically, Tyke is going to be much bigger with a high-powered battery and a better motor. The robotic arm will be included on it, so it can pick rocks up and move it out of the way. Also, it can pick itself up to go over rubble. A game controller support will be added, so you can control it with the Xbox or PS3 controller for ease of use and also faster movement. And obviously, I wanted to add a waterproof body to solve that first problem. And to help me with this, the Auckland University is offering me a summer research program with their researchers to help build Tyke better and also to learn more about robotics. And with that, Urban Search and Rescue have allowed me to work with them to research and develop Tyke so that one day they can use it as their primary research, the primary search and rescue method. So after all this, what I made and what I decided to think, what did I prove out of this and what did I achieve? I basically wasted 3 months working on this, but I actually looked at it and found that I did make something. And I've proved that a 15-year-old kid can go out of his living room and build a $200 robot. And authority and companies charge $5,000 for this. So they're basically ripping us off. I just don't understand why they had such a big market margin, because the value of life is much greater than the value of profit. So New Zealand's an innovative country. We built Oracle's boat. We built what beat us. But a controversial issue, I shouldn't have said that. But so we should push ourselves, and that's my challenge to companies out there. We should push ourselves to produce and sell cheaper technology, especially for life and death situations like Pike River. And this is a greater benefit to all of us. So can we go out there and do it? Or do we need another Pike River Mine? Do we need another Pike River Mine disaster to remind us of this? Thank you. Jason Meyer.